Dr. Gonzalez, thanks for taking time to talk with us today. Wanted to chat with you about these minimalist shoes that people are wearing these days. What's going on with them?
Well, I do think they're very popular. I feel that the shoe really changes the way you run. So that's probably the value in these shoes. So if you were looking to change your running mechanics from a rear strike runner to a 4-foot strike runner, these shoes would be beneficial for that. They essentially force you to become a 4-foot runner.
So can you show us what the difference is between a 4-foot and a heel strike runner?
Sure. So a rear strike or heel strike runner will, when they strike the ground, will land on their heels first and then come down onto your toes, where a 4-foot strike or mid-strike runner is going to land first on the 4-foot, usually the lateral 4-foot, and then roll into pronation as the heel comes down, but then you have to lower your heel down.
So if someone is determined to try these things, is there something they should think about or consider before they, you know, go out and run 6 miles in them? I mean, is there some process and thought there?
I would say absolutely. What you don't want to do is end up hurting yourself while you're trying to change your running pattern. So really the key to this is increasing the mileage, wearing such shoes very gradually. So you probably can't do it too gradually, but you could probably transition to running in such shoes too quickly and predispose yourself to injury, overuse injuries.
What type of injuries could occur?
I think anywhere from ligamentous muscle injuries to actually bone injuries, such as stress fractures of the foot, would be things that I'd be concerned about. So you really just want to start slow and steadily increase the mileage just in a minimal shoe.
All right, so besides just the gait changes, what are there other advantages to barefoot or minimalist running?
I think some of the ideas here regarding as you become a barefoot runner is it will strengthen your intrinsic foot muscles and potentially your calf muscles as well, so your gastrocs and your soleus muscle. And that would be an added benefit to running barefoot or in a minimal shoe. And that's a consequence essentially of running more on your 4-foot.
So the big thing you want to learn from these is what?
I'd say the take home to barefoot running or to minimal shoe running is that it changes your gait pattern to become from striking on your heel to striking on your 4-foot. So if you ever wanted to change your gait pattern, this would be one way to do that.
Well, Dr. Gonzalez, thank you for your time, and I appreciate your insight.
No problem. Thank you.